Welcome Blue Star School students. Today we are going to see about chapter number 12. Name is Ratio and Proportion in 6th Max NCERT book. Last video we saw exercise number 12.1 which was related to ratio. Now today we are going to see about exercise number 12.2 which is based on proportion. Let's see in detail. We have to write the definitions of proportion. Proportions and equality of two ratios is called proportion. Is called proportion. We have product of the middle term equal to product of the extreme term. Let's take an example. PQ RS. Proportion and equalities of two ratios is called proportion. It is nothing but it is a statement of equalities of ratio is called proportions. Okay, it is denoted by the symbol. This is okay. So we write P is to Q as R is to S. So we read P is to Q as R is to S. Okay. Here P, Q, R, S said to be the proportion. If P is to Q equal to R is to S. And okay. In proportion form we have to write it as P is to Q as R is to S. Where P, Q, R and S are respectively first, second, third and fourth term of the proportions. Here P and S that means P and S is we can call extreme term. Extreme term. Okay. And Q and R. Q and R as we can call middle term. This one is middle term. P and S is extreme term. This is extreme term. And Q and R is middle term. So what is the formula for product of proportion? Product of the middle term equal to product of the extreme term. So that is product of the middle term. Here middle term is represent Q and R. So QR product means multiplication. So QR equal to product of the extreme term. Extreme term means it represent P and S. So this is called proportion. Next we have to move the exercise number 12.2. Let's see the example problem 12.2. Take down the first sum. Determine if the following are in proportion. Following are in proportion. Let we take the substitution A is nothing but 15, 45, 40 and 120. Okay. We have to find the proportions of these four numbers. So what do you mean by proportions? Equalities of two ratio. Equalities of two ratio. This is the one of the ratio. First we have to find the ratio between 15 and 45. This is the another ratio we have to find, 40:120. Then we have to compare these two ratios. First we have to find the ratios of 15 and 45. Ratio of 15 and 45 is, ratio means divide. So 15 divided by 45. We have to cancel in 15 table. 1 15 is 15. 3 15 is 45. That is 1/3. We can call 1:3 in ratio form. Next we have to find the ratio of another two number, that is 40 and 120. Here also we have to make it as simplest form. First we have to cancel in 0, then reducible by 4 table. 1 4 is 4, 3 4 is 12. So here also we get 1/3, that is 1:3. Now compare these two ratios. It's all same. So this is called proportion. So we can write it as 15:45 equal to 40:120. It is nothing but the ratio of 15 and 45 equal to the ratio of 40 and 120. So here therefore 15, 45, 40 and 120 are in proportion. This is our answer. Next we have to move subdivision D. 32, 48, 70, 210. Here also we have to find the proportion. First step, what will we do? We have to do ratio of two pairs. First we have to find the ratio of 32 and 48. 32 by 48. Now cancel. We have to cancel in 2 table. 2 ones are 2, remainder 1, 16. 2 fours are 2 twos are 4, 4 twos are 8, so 24. Again we have to cancel in 4 table. 4 fours are 16. 6 fours are 24. Again we have to cancel in 2 table. 2 twos are 4. 3 twos are 6. Next, further we did not reducible. So we get 2 by 3. We can write 2 is to 3. This is the ratio of 32 and 48. Next, we have to find ratio of 70 and 210. 70 by 210. We have to cancel first. 0 0 cancel. Next we have to cancel in 7 table. 1 7 are 7. 3 7 are 21. Okay. So we can write 1 divided by 3. That is 1 is to 3. What is the second step? We have to compare the two equalities of the ratios. Okay, two pair of the ratio. Now compare this one. Here 2 is to 3 is not equal to 1 is to 3. So 32 is to 48. The ratio of 32 and 42 is not equal to the ratio of 70 is to 120. So, therefore, 32, 48, 70 and 220 are not in proportion because the value not same. Okay, next we have to move the subdivision gap. That is 33, 44, 75 and 100. So here first we have to find the ratio of first two number, first two term, that is 33 and 44. 33 divided by 44. We have to cancel in which table? 11 table. 11 threes are 33, 11 fours are 44. So the answer is 3 by 4 in fractional form. We have to write in ratio form 3 is to 4. Next we have to find the ratio between 75 and 100. Now we have to cancel in 25 table. 3 25s are 75. 4 25s are 100. So we get the answer 3 by 4. 3 is to 4. Now compare these two number, ratio of 33 and 44 equal to ratio of 75 and 100. Both are same. Equal number. So therefore 33 is to 44 equal to 75 is to 100. So therefore, 33, 44, 75 and 100 are in proportion. We write the fourth question. Determine if the following ratios form a proportion. Also, write the middle term and extreme term. Bear the ratio form a proportion. Let me take the first subdivision. 25 centimeter is to 1 meter and rupees 40 is to rupees 160. Determine if the following ratio form in the proportions. Also write the middle term and extreme term where the ratio form a proportion. Okay. So, in this sum, first we have to check whether the given two ratios are proportions or not. Okay. Then, if it is proportion, means we have to find the middle term and extreme term of proportion. Let me see the first sum. First step, what will we do? We have to check it is proportion or not. So we first we have to find the ratio of 25 centimeter and 1 meter. Okay. First we have to calculate these two numbers. Now what do we see here at the first look? Here centimeter, here meters are not same unit. So we have to change in the same kind of unit. So we have to convert minute into centimeter. Okay. We can write 25 centimeter divided by 1 meter. 25 centimeter. Already we know 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. So we can write in bracket 1 meter equal to how many centimeter? 100 centimeter. Okay. Next we have to cancel in 25 table. 125 are 25, 425 are 100. So we get 1 by 4, that is 1 is to 4. Next we have to find ratio of other pair, that is rupees 40 and ₹160. Here same unit, so we need not change anything. We have to just find the answer. We have to cancel in 4 table. 1 4s are 4, 4 4s are 16. So we get the answer 1/4, that is 1:4. What is the second step? We have to compare these two ratios. Equal. Two ratios are equal. So therefore, 25 centimeter is to 1 meter equal to ₹40 is to ₹160. So therefore, the ratios are equal. So therefore, 25 centimeter, 1 meter, ₹40, and ₹60 are in proportion. So this four number is proportion. Next, what will we do? We have to find the middle term and extreme term of this number. Okay. So here, which one is middle term? This is middle term. This one is middle term. This is extreme term. These two are extreme term. So we have to write here middle terms are middle terms equal to 1 meter and ₹40. Extreme. Extreme term is 25 centimeter and ₹160. These are the answer for this sum. Next, we have to take substitution C. 2 kilogram, 80 kg, and 25 gram is to 625 gram. This is our question. We have to find whether the given equations are, given two ratios are proportions or not. So ratio of 2 kg and 80 kg equal to, here unit are same. So we write simply, we have to cancel in 2 table. We get the answer 1/4. 1/4, that is 1:4. Next, we have to find the ratio of 25 gram and 625 gram. So here also we have to cancel in 25 table. 125 are 25, 25 are 625. So we get the answer 1/25, that is 1:25. Okay, now compare these two numbers. Here 2 kg, 80 gram, 80 kilogram, so 80. So we get the answer 40. So 1:40. Here the ratio is different. So it is not same. So 2 kilogram is to 80 kilogram is not equal to the ratio of 25 gram is to 625 gram. So the ratios are not equal. So these four number are these are not in proportion. Next, let's see the homework problem. This is your homework sum in exercise number 12.2. First sum B, C, and E subdivision, and fourth sum B and D. Okay, thank you, students.